Hi, this is Anil from LearningLad and welcome to another video on C++ programming language. Now, in this video, we will learn about using the range in the switch statement's case values. So here I have already created a sample program. In this program, I have created an integer variable called x and I have stored 10 in this variable x. And then we have the switch statement, and in the switch expression part, we have this variable x. And then we have some cases inside this switch. The first case is with the value of 10, and we have some statements for that. And then we have another case with the value of 200, and then we have the default case. Now, if I save this program, build and run this, then you guys can see we get the output as case value 1 statements. That's because this x variable is containing a value of 10. And this 10 will match with the case value 10, and that's why the statements which are for the case with the value of 10 will be executed. So first we have the cout, so it's gonna print out case value 1 statements to the screen, and then we have this break statement, and that's why the switch statement will terminate here when it encounters this break statement. The control will come out of this switch statement and it will execute rest of the other statements. And here in this program, we don't have any other statements which are printing or displaying some values to the screen. So here, if you want to execute the same set of statements for multiple case values, then you can specify them together. For example, I can specify another case here, like case 20, or maybe like case 30. I can specify cases with values together like this, and then I can specify the statements that I want to execute for all these values. So here in this case, for the values 10, 20 and 30, this statement that I have highlighted here will be executed. For example, just to demonstrate that, if I change the value to 30 and if I build and run this program, you guys can see case value 1 statements. That's because this 30 will match with the case value of 30 here, and it will execute this statement. Now, this is one way if you want to execute the same set of statements for more than one case values. Now, the next thing is, what if you want to execute the same set of statements for a range of values? For example, what if you want to execute a set of statements for the values from 1 to 99? So at that time, you have one option, and that is to specify all those values of that range like this. For example, you can specify like 1, 2, 3 and up to 99, and then you can write the statements that you want to execute. But what if the range size increases? What if you want to execute the same set of statements for the range from 1 to 1000? So at that time, specifying the case values like this is not going to be the solution. So for that problem, we have a solution, and the solution is to specify the range of values in the place of case values. For example, in this program, these case values are constant values. They are one value, 1 or 2 or 3. And here you can specify the range of values also. This feature is right now available only in the GCC compiler. Most of the other compilers are not supporting at the time I'm making this video. Let's see how we can use this range in the case values. Now, before using that, let's talk about the syntax of using the range in the case values of a switch statement. So first you write the keyword case, and then you leave a space, and then you specify the lower limit of the range, and then you leave a space, and then you add 3 dots, and then again you leave a space, and then you specify the upper limit of the range, and then you add the colon, and then you can specify the statements that you want to execute. So here, for the demonstration purpose, if I have to execute the same set of statements for a range of values from 1 to 99, then I can specify that here like this. So first I have to write the keyword case, and then I need to add a space, and then I need to specify the lower part of the range. So here we want to execute the set of statements for the values from 1 up to 99. So the lowest value of that range will be 1, and then I need to leave a space, and then I need to add 3 dots and then a space, and then I need to specify the upper value of that range, which is 99, and then I can add the colon and I can write the statements. Here what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change this one to the value, and then I'm gonna refer for that variable x, and then I'm gonna say is between 1 and 99. Okay, now I'm gonna save this, and then I'm gonna go to build, and I'll do build and run, and the output is the value 30 is between 1 and 99. So that's the output we are getting here. Now what happened here is the x variable is containing a value of 30, and that value falls within this range, and that's why the statements which we have written for this first case will be executed here. Now the next thing is, when you use the range of values in the case value of the switch statement, for the rest of the case values, if you want, you can use the range, or you can use the constant values like the way we have done here. It's totally up to you, depending on the way you want to program. And also you can specify more case values together if you want to execute same set of statements for all those values. For example, here I can add another case with a value of 300, or I can also specify the range if I want. So all that options are available. So you can do all these things and it will work properly. So, you know, here I'm specifying a constant value here and it will work totally fine. And also if you want, you can specify the range like 200, 300 to 400, or, you know, something like that. You can specify the range also. So it will work. Just to demonstrate that, I'm going to change this one to 300. And here, you know, we're going to keep this statement as it is. And we're going to build and run this, and now you guys can see the value 300 is between 1 and 99, but you know it is not between 1 and 99, but the main thing is, you know, these statements are executed for, you know, this range of values. So that's the main thing. Don't go for this value is between 1 and 99. So, you know, you can use it in all these ways. Now the next thing that we're gonna talk about is, there are some rules you need to follow while using this feature, that is to specify the range of values in the case of a switch statement. And the first rule is, while specifying the range, the lower value of the range should not be higher than the upper value of the range. For example, you can't specify a range of values from 199 to 99 like this. You know, the here for this range, the beginning value of this range is greater than the end value of this range, and you know, this is not allowed. And here I'll quickly change this value to 30, and then I'm gonna do build and run, and here you guys can see the output is default case statements. We get the default case here because I need to show you guys the logs to explain what happened here. Okay, now here what happened is, for this case, the first part of the range that we have specified has the value which is greater than the last part of the range that we have specified. And that's why the compiler is generating this warning, empty range specified. The compiler generates a warning and it treats it as an empty range. And here in this program, what happened is, when we run this program, I have set this code blocks IDE to ignore all the warnings and run the program if any warning appears. And here the compiler has generated a warning and it treated it as an empty range. And then the x is containing a value of 30, and none of the other case values are matching with this, and that's why the default case has been executed. So this is the first rule that we have, that you have to remember. Now another rule that you have to remember is, while specifying the range in the case values of the switch statement, you need to make sure that none of the case values are overlapping. which is nothing but you need to make sure that for a particular value, only one case has a match, which is nothing but, for example, the first case that we have specified has a range from 1 to 99. So it will match for all those values from 1 to 99. Then I can't have another case with a value of 20. That's because for the value of 20, we have two case matches here and it is not allowed. So while using the range, or you know, if you're not using the range also, then you need to make sure that for a particular value, only one case has the match. So these are the two things you have to remember. In this case, for the value of 20, we have two matches, or you know, two cases can match. And if I try to build and run this program, I'll get the error. And if I open up the error logs, it says a duplicate case value. So that's the error we're gonna get if we have more than one matches in the cases for a particular value. So these are the two rules that you have to remember. Now here, for the demonstration purpose, I have used the integer variable. You can use the characters also. That's because for the characters, the ASCII values are used. I want you guys to experiment with that character part. Now I want you guys to write a simple program where you will be asking the user to enter an alphabetical character. And when the user is going to enter an alphabetical character, you will say whether the user has entered the uppercase character or the lowercase character using this switch range method. Try to write that program post your source code in the comment box. This is it, guys. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, then hit the dislike button. If you want to watch more tutorials, then do subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you later in the next video.